your this day's target? Like, for example, now after going to, you know, to the room, what I should do? You should have your mental framework already fixed. Like, after going to room, if possible, I'll go to the library, I'll study these things. You should, you know, keep it in your mind and then execute it. Everyone knows everything, in fact. I told it in the first thing itself. Like, it doesn't mean that as an adult being, we already know what needs to be done, what need not to be done for this exam. It is execution. And execution is very boring. That's why we need our own self-motivation. Okay, and in case if you do not get the motivation, you can externally inject that motivation through YouTube videos. Like, you know, you can watch any of the movies like Subhash Chandra movies, Gandhi movie, and then you can watch for entertainment sake this thing, Pradhan Mantri series. It will help you to build your, you know, post-independent knowledge for mains. You should, you know, channelize like 24/7 kind of UPSC. You should infuse this UPSC thing in your subconscious mind. If you inject your, you always, if you think about UPSC in your dream also, then you will surely be in, okay? You should have that, you know, mental state of mind. And also, let me tell you also, ki, don't take it as a matter of life and death question, no. It is a battle zone, yes, but only as long as we are battling here. Unfortunately, if you are not able to survive, if you are not able to qualify, life will not end. Life is always awesome. Life is always filled with the ups and downs. If a person has tasted success today, means that same person will taste the failure again in one or other field. And that same person again will rise. This is all a sine wave. It's not a philosophy. It is just a truth of life. Everyone, no matter which background, I have come from a very modest background. That doesn't mean that I will only have, you know, scaling up now. Some of my friends are there, they have born with golden spoons. That doesn't mean that they don't have problems. Everyone will be having their own set of problems. So, UPSC preparation is just an academic pursuit. Okay, if you get it, well and good. If not, Indian economy is booming, everyone will get the job, provided if you possess hard work and the skill set. So, just prepare well. Prepare, you know, put your honest efforts, and before going to the bed, you should be satisfied with your own performance. Are you getting it?
Whatever we are going for next 100 days, it is for free, right? So it will help to mains also?
Yeah, this is very...
Yeah, it is, obviously, I know that. But what is the difference between mains preparation and perspective?
See, in prelims preparation...
It would not like that. You just have to crack the pre, right?
So
mains is also important.
Exactly.
So, next 100 days, whatever we are going to read, so what we should...
These 100 days, whatever 100 days work you will do, this is the building block for your mains. Automatically you will build. For example, if you read anything for at least 2 times or 3 times in the remaining 100 days, and then you have to repeat the same thing again for the mains also. You had read it from the factual information, at that time, you will read it from the analytical point of view. You will be having factual information. While writing, you just need to identify the answer in prelims, which already is there in front of you. There you have to create your own answer. And if you have the factual information at your disposal, which you have gained in this 100 days, your answer stand apart from the someone. Answer writing may, if I write an answer, I do not include any facts. I just, you know, give some more generalistic statements. But you will write generalistic statements with facts. Then you will be very much different from mine. And you will be awarded for that. Are you getting it? So that is the difference which this 100 days will make. So whatever you read for the prelims is the solid foundation for the mains. And based on this also, based on this only, you will get, you know, good marks in the mains. Mains ke liye jyada kuch nahi padhna hai except newspapers. Newspapers is very much relevant there because they will ask you from the analytical bent of mind. Okay, what else? Any other questions? just let me know in case any questions. I'll be available on the Telegram also at my ID. @GIRISHKALAGOND @ So you can text me for any query if you want. So I have already covered everything whatever I wanted to cover, like including, you know, test series and then static source. Just take it very relaxed and enjoy this process, okay? It is very difficult. I know it is easier said than done. But if you can enjoy this process, if you can enjoy this process, you will definitely, you know, qualify in this exam. It's like, you know, if you are happy doing what you are doing, then no force on this earth can stop you what you want to achieve, okay? Just be happy with the process. Automatically, it will take care of everything. If you have set a goal, there is, you know, focus on goal, focus on goal. Many people you might have heard saying, you should not focus on the goal. Goal you have already fixed. If you want to become IAS, fixed. Goal is fixed already. You focus on the process now. What to do to become an IAS? You just focus on that. And let me also tell you ki getting, you know, into the UPSC rank list is not a big deal. You will get into the rank list. But getting into the IAS itself, it is very much big deal. Why? Because in the Indian bureaucratic system, still IAS is considered as one of the most good services. It doesn't mean that all other services are bad. No, comparatively, IAS has more responsibilities than any other services. So that's why we all are aiming for it. Everyone starts this preparation mainly to enter either IAS, Indian Foreign Service, or IPS. Usually, some people also with income tax, okay? So you just identify, and if you are preparing very average on below average, you will get into the rank list, but not with extraordinary score to get into IAS. So your preparation should be such that if you can get the mains, you know, call, if you can able to qualify in the prelims, you should convert it into the rank, okay? Last time, and without job, it is very much difficult. Without job security, that future uncertainty will always haunt us, okay? For all of us, almost all of us are from middle class only. So there will be a lot of financial constraints, a lot of future uncertainties. So you have to tackle all those things by putting maximum efforts. So whenever I was working, right, I told, I resigned from the job. So my brother advised me, my younger brother advised me, saying that don't think that you are out of the job, you are in the job only, and that job is preparing for the UPSC. While I was working for an IT company, I used to go to the office at 8:30 and come to the room at 6:30 or 7 o'clock in the evening. Okay, just think that around 10 to 12 hours of work in the office. So do the same thing. Consider like you wake up at 8 o'clock. By 9 o'clock, you should be in library, and 12 o'clock in the night, you should be out of the library. That's a job for you. You will be getting, you will not be getting paid for it, at least now, you will be getting paid for it in future, but think it as a job. You are doing a job, and do it sincerely. Earlier, I used to do a job for someone else, but I used to take just a salary. But now, I am doing this job for myself, my own startup company. So you just think like that, and then everything will fall in line. And this not more than 1 hour away from the library. If you are studying in the libraries, this you have to follow, okay? Otherwise, things will not be okay. And don't give up anything thinking that mujhse nahi ho payega. It's all about mindset. If you can able to practice anything for 21 days, let me assure you, it will become a routine for you. So you do this, I think hopefully you will all get through, and after the prelims, we will definitely again meet, okay? And for any query, you can approach me here. And they are also conducting the current affairs classes, and if anybody has not covered anything till now, you can, you know, approach them. You can join their current affairs classes starting today, and they will cover everything, like last 2 years ka. And consolidation of the 2 years current affairs, how will you do that? Either you can join them, or if you want to prepare on your own, there is a PT365 compilation by some different institutes like Insights, Vision, Shankarais, like that. You can take 2017 or 18 ka compilations. Like if you are weak in sub like environment and then you know some science and technology, you can take that and read only those things. And rest of the things, anyway, it will be updated. So for last 2 years, you can read only the PT materials of the different institute, or you will anyway join these institute, okay, for the current affairs coverage. I hope I have made the things clear. This is one very much thing. I had forgotten about this. CSAT is like very like deciding factor in your, you know, either becoming a bureaucrat or just a civil service aspirant. CSAT, despite coming from the engineering background or IIT background, many people have failed. I know one of my friend, he always used to score 110 plus in one paper, having OBC category. Okay, OBC category 110 plus means it's like more than sufficient for the GS1 score. But he failed twice in the CSAT paper. CSAT paper mein he failed twice. That means he had extremely brilliant, you know, knowledge on the general studies. Okay, he is very much knowledgeable. His analysis, I had thanked him after my, you know, result, because based on interaction with him, I had improved my analytical skills also. So his analysis, his way of writing, expressional skills, awesome. But he had failed in the CSAT. What is the use of it? So don't take anything on CSAT lightly. You don't have to invest much of the time. 10 minutes for feeling anxious about the CSAT, 10 minutes from today onwards till the another 100 days. If you are not from the engineering background or IIT background like that, 10 minutes only. Simply focus on one concept like time, or else distance, or else average, or else, you know, pipes, cisterns, like aptitude questions. And in CSAT, never ever depend on the comprehension questions. Even if you are an Oxford graduate, don't ever depend on that, you know, English comprehension. It's very tricky. So always depend on the mathematics. Initially, you know, me, CSAT was the biggest difficulty actually. Now, it is an irony that I never worried about the GS1 paper. Only for CSAT I used to worry a lot in the last, you know, leg of the exam. I had got around 72 marks in my first attempt in 2015 when I had given, and then around 70 marks in the second attempt, and then when I qualified in the third attempt, I had got 84 marks like in 2017. In 2018, fortunately, I had got around 104 to 110 in that range. So I had got this much marks in the CSAT exam. That means always I worried CSAT qualify karne ke liye to 67 chahiye. So I always was on a border range. And in 2018, CSAT question paper was very easy. So I could able to score 104. Why? Because I never used to thinking that I am an engineer. So why I have to work on CSAT? This was my mindset. I never worked, and my weakest subject was mathematics, like quants. Even in my campus interview, I had worked only for 2 days for quantitative aptitude to qualify the first round of the companies. Apart from that, quants I hated like anything. My English was good comparatively. Though I have studied in my vernacular medium till 10th standard, my English, and that too in a government school in a rural area, but still my English is good thanks to my high school teachers. So I always depended on comprehension, but still comprehension I advise to avoid. It's very tricky, and without practice you cannot ease through this. So CSAT ke liye, no need to refer any books and all. If you can watch a video of 10 minutes available on the YouTube of anything, okay, or else you can just refer the quantitative aptitude by RS Agarwal. That's a bible for CSAT usually, even for the campus recruitments. So apart from that, Arihant, you can, you know, if at all, Arihant book naam ka cheez hai CSAT ke liye, or else your coaching, you know, class ka notes CSAT ka. If you can do this, it's easy to get, you know, 80 marks in CSAT. don't neglect it. It's very important. And 10 minutes per day, you can do that. Okay, I guess I have covered everything. And wish you all the very best, and you can approach, you know, anytime on this ID. Okay, all the very best to all.